All right, so let's talk about the circle whose center is at 8, 0 and has radius 4. And this is the Cartesian equation of that circle. So our goal is to write the parametric equations for this circle, assuming that we want to move clockwise, but starting at the leftmost point. So what I'm going to look at is a circle whose center is at the origin and has the same radius. So we're going to say it's radius 4. So we know that that means this point here is negative 4, 0. This point over here is at 4, 0. And again, we want to trace out the circle going clockwise. So we know that there's some kind of combination of cosine and sine happening here. So in fact, since the circle is starting on the horizontal axis, we know it's going to have something to do with 4 cosine t, and y is going to have something to do with 4 sine t. And that's where t is going from 0 to 2 pi. So that's, however, though, when we're starting at 4, 0, the rightmost point, and turning counterclockwise. So we're going to have to adjust the cosine and sine somehow to make sure that this is going the right direction, starting at the right point. Well, so looking at this, if you notice, you know, if I start at this point right here, the negative 4, 0, x is increasing from there. Let's just review a little bit how the cosine and sine functions work. So cosine, as we know, at x equals 0 or t equals 0, starts high, decreases from there, and then starts to increase halfway through and keeps going that way. Sine will start at 0, increase to the high point, then decrease to the low point, and so on and so on. So looking at this, I have x starting at its lowest point and increasing toward its highest point, which is the exact opposite of this one here. So I'm going to put a negative in front of the 4 cosine t, and that makes that right. Now, the y coordinate, though, is starting at 0, going up, and then going down, and then going up again. That is totally in line with what the sine function is. So we have our parametric equations for the circle centered at the origin right here, x equals negative 4 cosine t, y equals 4 sine t. So coming over here to the original problem, now what happens when I move that center to 8, 0? Well, it's actually quite simple. The x coordinate just increases by 8 and the y coordinate stays the same. So we're going to have x equals negative 4 cosine t plus 8 and y equals 4 sine of t. And again, trying to keep it on that magical domain of 0 to 2 pi to make it one revolution, there we have it. So this right here is one of the many ways to parameterize that circle. What are some other things you could do? You could change the domain if you wanted to. You notice that the first angle is pi. You go from pi to 3 pi and then get creative with how you write your functions. But that said, there's just a lot of ways to do this. So this way to me just seems the most straightforward. So I thank you for taking the time to watch. I hope this helps, and watch out for more videos.